No.
This is just filming for you guys.
Why?
We have to do for homework. I was telling you. So bring it in. So yeah, make sure they can see you. Good. Let's angle the camera.
Yeah.
The first half of the prep course. I'm going through two classes. Usually the prep course lasts for 5 days. The first 4 days, we go through all the stuff, and the last day, usually take like the class. Usually half. Class, the coach goes through and stuff. So, first you're going to learn the squat. If I can spell that. Squat. Then you're going to learn the front squat. Overhead squat. Depending on how you do with that, that's day one. This is day one of prep course. And then day two, which is called the pressing series. So you do press, push press, and push jerk. I'm going to try to teach you guys the first six movements today. Depending on how you guys do this. I know that you've done NC Express Quick Fit. NC Express Fit or whatever. But you have you done a pop before? Okay, so you probably know the squat. Alright, so when you go with that, the squat will probably come pretty naturally. The press will see. Alright? And if that's gonna happen, I'm gonna go through a wad and I make up depending on how you guys do with all this. Usually the classes take about an hour or so. Depending on the individual, right? Some people can walk a little bit of squats, some people can't go squat, some people can squat right away. So if they can do something right away, they'll be just like, oh, you can squat, do the next thing. Or if they're part of the next part, you can do it as fast as you go. Alright, so if they can tell, then maybe we want you to try to go squat. Alright, so before I start, does anybody have any injuries? Smiley?
Yeah.
Party too much? No?
Maybe a little.
Maybe a little?
Maybe my head hurts.
So, let's talk about the squat. The first thing is the stance, right? Your feet should be shoulder width apart. Good, and your toes should be slightly tilted up. Slightly tilted up. Awesome. Good, a little bit more. Unless you're super flexible. If you're super flexible, you can have your feet straight forward, and most people, they have a slight tilt up. Right? So the squat looks like this. This is the squat. Motion, all what you guys do is send your hips, send your hips back and down, and want your weight to keep your dominant in the motion. Alright, so don't go down, up on your toes, get back to the heels, get your butt back and down, and you're sitting on the world's smallest chair. So, I got my key, when I see down, go down, when I see up, you're gonna come up. Alright, ready? Down. Out and you're finding your feet kind of turn like this, like Scarlett kind of did there, right? What you want to think about is keeping your front foot clamped down on the ground. Kind of grab, okay? So we don't want our feet to be moving while we're squatting, right? So what we got there? Oh yeah, so now pull up the range of motion, right? Jenny, when we first started, the range of motion that we can do for a squat, just hips fully the same at the top, the bottom, and the fitness for the top. Okay, that's the full squat, that's the this is borderline. I like to see this. Using this, so we can test.
Nothing, you were looking in the mirror.
I'm making sure that goes in there. My hair. My little hair I have left. I'm more stress here, I think. So, we have standards in every single movement. The main reason for that is for safety, right? If you have a full range of motion, it's going to your joints because of a partial range of motion. And also, that way we can retest a workout. So, I'll say, Jenny, I'll say, give me 10 air squats right now. And she's just like this. This is 10 in 5 seconds. You're all like quarter squats. And then, like, say a month later, you learn the correct full depth and full range of motion. In 10 seconds, you do like one or two squats. You're like, man, in 2 months, I've lost fitness. And no, you're just reaching full range of motion. So if you have some sort of standard, you can retest how fitness to get more jack. Which we want, right? More jack, you get more boys.
Yay!
Yeah! Ready? I'm on IQ. Ready? And down. Yeah, ladies. Up. Good. And down. Up. And down. And up. Down. Up. And we're last. Good job. Yeah.
Yeah.
We're all getting lollipops. Woo! Alright, so, Hi, Matt. Hi, Sonia. Hello.
Hello.
Right, I love your leggings, by the way. They're so lovely. Yeah.
Oh, my God.
They're so cute.
I don't know. Anyway, so the next last thing is lumbar curve. All right? So your lower back right here, you want to maintain kind of a little, like, yeah, nice little butt out kind of thing. Okay? You don't want to be rounded like this. That was interesting what I said there. So you don't want it to round, you want to maintain a flat back. The reason why is when you have load on your back and your back is rounded, obviously that's not a good position for your spine to be on when under load. Does that make sense? So in order to practice to do that, what I'm gonna have you ladies do is have your hands up in the air. Alright? And how you can. I'm gonna come by, when I tell you to go down, you're gonna go down, alright? Go ahead and go down and not touch my hand. Okay, you fall over, that's alright. So that's what you guys are going to do, okay? Put both of you guys' hands up. Jenny thinks this is dumb. I can tell with your face. This is not dumb. Look forward. Good job, lady. Ready. You squat for your job. Ready. Well, I'm on my foot. Down. Up. Down. Up. You too. While she's doing it. Down.
Okay.
Up. Down. So, at the bottom, I want you to, you're letting yourself collapse. Just stay tight at the bottom. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
The bottom, you're going to finish up like that. So, maybe that needs to, like, go up a little bit higher at the bottom. That's okay. That's right. Hands up here. And down. There you go. Up. Good. Don't touch my hand at all. And down. Up. Good. Much better. Down. Up. And relax. Woo! You lazy to drink water?
No.
Want to take your shawl off?
It's a cardigan.
Sorry, a cardigan.
Get it right.
Jenny probably got me sick.
After today, she will.
You're making me work out and move.
notice that the bar is lifting the weight of my chin. It's going to have to do it before I get the bar now flat on my delts. Alright, my triceps are pretty tight, so the bar actually wants to kind of handle my right here. Alright, was there some weight there, or like some pressure for my chin? Then it won't. My water, my delts, I won't look like a fumble under the right? You ladies are quite flexible. So, let's talk about the grip of the front squat. You want to have a thumb distance from your quads. Alright, your stance is in the same, your squat stance. Good. Everything with the squat that we just learned remains. Alright, so with the heels, chest up, legs out, all that remains the same. Okay? Now, you're going to lift it up here, put your elbows underneath. It should rise on your toes. It should roll back. And you should your two or three fingers. Okay, so high. Piggybacks off the basic air squat, right? Except your hand position, and you have a load on, right? It's very important when you're doing movement to make sure your elbows stay high, okay? If you don't, the elbows will drop, and the top will get elbow drop. The weight's going to go forward, the bar can go forward, okay? If you're high reps or a lot of weight, you don't want to do that. You want to stay back in the heels, keep the elbows up high. Pretty simple, right? Awesome. Sweet. So, keep the next movement. Overhead squat. Woohoo! What? Are you excited for this?
Gains!
Have you ever done overhead squat before?
No.
Have you ever done a front squat before?
No.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Good. So, this is the most difficult of all the squatting movements. That's why it's going to be last. Alright? You're now going to have the object placed overhead. So, I'm first going to go over your grip. Your stance is exactly the same. Okay? All you're going to do is you're going to squat with your shoulders shoulder up in the ear. You call these active shoulders. Down. Alright, even though it's my foot kind of slightly down, it's a slightly wider stance for me because I have ankle mobility problems. Alright? So don't get